Hello guys, my name is Yash. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will learn about Java polymorphism, their types, and its implementation with the help of examples. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Also, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe so that you don't miss any updates. Polymorphism is an important concept of object-oriented programming. Polymorphism in Java is a concept by which we can perform a single action in different ways. Polymorphism is derived from two Greek words, poly and morphs. The word poly means many and morphs means forms, so polymorphism means many forms. There are two types of polymorphism in Java, compile-time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism. We can perform polymorphism in Java by method overloading and method overriding. If you overload a static method in Java, it is the example of compile-time polymorphism. And runtime polymorphism is the process in which a call to an overridden method is resolved at runtime rather than compile time. In this example, we have created a superclass programming and two subclasses C and Java. Notice the use of language method. The main purpose of the language method is to print languages. However, the process of both classes are different. Hence, the language method behaves differently in different classes. Or we can say language method is polymorphic. Polymorphism allows us to create consistent code. In the previous example, we can also create different methods like C language and Java language to print languages respectively. This will work perfectly. However, for every language, we need to create different methods. It will make our code inconsistent. To solve this, polymorphism in Java allows us to create a single method language that will behave differently for different languages. We can achieve polymorphism in Java using the following ways: method overriding, method overloading, operator overloading. In this example, we have created a superclass named language and a subclass named programming lang. Here, the display method is present in both language and programming lang. The use of display method is to print the information. However, it is printing different information in both classes, language and programming lang. Based on the object used to call the method, the corresponding information is printed. In this example, we have created a class named Overload. The class contains a method named Display that is overloaded. Here, the main function of Display method is to print the information. However, based on the arguments passed, the method is performing different operations. Some operators in Java behave differently with different operands. For example, plus operator is overloaded to perform numeric addition as well as string concatenation. And operators like AND, OR are overloaded for logical and bitwise operations. The plus operator is used to add two entities. However, in Java, the plus operator performs two operations. First, when plus is used with numbers, it performs mathematical addition. And second, when we use the plus operator with strings, it will perform string concatenation. Here, we can see that the plus operator is overloaded in Java to perform two operations, addition and concatenation. A variable is called polymorphic if it refers to different values under different conditions. Object variables represent the behavior of polymorphic variables in Java. It is because object variables of a class can refer to objects of its class as well as object of its subclass. For example, in this example, we have created an object variable AL of the AssemblyLang class. Here, AL is a polymorphic variable. This is because here AL refer to the object of the AssemblyLang class. Here AL refer to the object of MachineLang class. If you like this video, share it with your friends and also don't forget to like.